In the field, that's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil and all this loose thing, the freshman ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the
today, from Empower Field, that Mile High in Denver. It's week three of the NFL on EA Sports. Broncos taking on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
We find ourselves at the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, for this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Just a short time ago, sounds loud enough to reverberate across the Rockies. They're ready for football in Denver as the Broncos get set to do battle with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And hello again, everyone. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. They come in losers of two straight, so they're trying to right the ship here a little bit.
They're teetering a little bit, aren't they? And now things could really go south if they lose this game, so they understand the importance of playing well and stopping this streak.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Bucs, they were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Carry for Leonard Fournette, and they're able to get this one across the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Now this one complete on the slant route. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first.
First down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
They run on first down as they're able to get this forward for about four. In a word, I would say productive, finding the end zone three different times.
Is it possible that you're really underselling it? Three touchdowns, you're going to call him productive?
What do you want?
This guy had a nose for the end zone.
He was good.
Had a snootful, didn't he? How about that? Big time game.
Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Airing this one out for Evans. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Not the desired outcome, but probably won't be the last time we see him take a shot downfield.
They'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down. Play action, now it's Brady. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Hudson. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of eight there.
First down.
Nice job keeping that opening drive alive. And they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them. And now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone. Because the closer you get, to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
On first down, Brady. It's complete. He's got Gronk. And down inside the 15 he goes. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
First down, Tampa Bay.
There it is, partner. Brady to Gronk. Their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football. As is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
First and goal from just inside the five. Now Brady. This will be caught at about the five. And he gets halfway there from the four to the two on a gain of two. That catch good for only a couple. One back in the game. That's Jones, second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two.
The ball carrier brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Third and goal now, mere inches from Pater. Shotgun now for Brady. Good work by that Bronco defense, and it leads to a fourth down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Buccaneers 3, Broncos nothing.
They moved the ball pretty well there on the opening drive. You think they're okay settling for three?
I don't think they're happy about settling for three, but I think you're exactly right with the word okay, because they threw it well, they ran it well. Excellent balance for the first drive of the game.
And this will come out to the 25 as Hamler elects not to return it. So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by their mobile quarterback, standing 6'4", it's Colin Kaepernick.
And I saw that he had an interesting quote in the research packet that we had after last week's game. It's all on me now. I've got to lead my team and find a way for us to win a game. 0-2, but they're at home. I guess he's going to try and find a way to get the home crowd involved early.
On play action, it's Kaepernick. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. And it's hauled in by Nick Bonnet.
Kaepernick's pass.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was going for the tight end, Nick Vanette. But now it's third down. They have the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big, looking to get it to Ward, intercepted. picked off by Levante David. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line.
They'll take over.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to hands of the wrong team.
They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
The tackle made by Shelby.
He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
The throw there by Brady, intended for Gronkowski, but incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and it's 3rd and 4.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Now Brady. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
Ronald Jones.
They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards.
First down, Buccaneers.
That's just what you call a chain mover right there. Nothing fancy. Get the ball out to the back, and you're asking him to make a little bit extra out of maybe what is nothing. And he does exactly that, picks up the first down. I can't wait till we get to the point, partner, where we're not saying chain mover, but we're saying laser pointer picks it up for the first down.
They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. A give to Jones. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
To throw on 2nd and 6. Brady, and he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. The sack there by Bradley Chubb.
But that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on 3rd down. Brady. He's got Evans. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Touchdown.
Mike Evans. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead.
It's never fun for a defense to run on the field knowing that they're having to defend a short field. Just the idea of trying to limit an offense in that position, daunting for a defense.
It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Hamler elects not to return it. So now the 2nd drive offensively coming up for the Denver Broncos. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it 1st and 10. The drive will commence with a run by Lindsey. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
He's tackled at the 30.
When you're down early, how do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
Denver Broncos.
10-0 the score after one on EA Sports.
Buccaneers 10, Broncos nothing.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 14 yards there and a Denver first down.
I know people see Philip Lindsay's role in Denver changing a bit with the arrival of Melvin Gordon, but I think Gordon's going to be more of an enhancement for Lindsay. Maybe he won't carry it as often, but now he'll be much more effective as a two-headed monster in the backfield. Both of them can run it inside, get to the perimeter, and catch the ball out of the backfield and move the sticks.
And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Taken down at the 41. A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6.
Now Kaepernick throwing on 2nd down. Underneath pass here to Van Ed. And this is going to lead to another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 30. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. And movement by one of the Broncos up front. And in comes the flag.
Offense.
Maybe anticipating a blitz, and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up, and they jumped.
A false start backs them up 5, 1st and 15. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. Call it a gain of 5, and that'll make it 2nd and 10. He's a second-round pick, a solid second-round pick, but when you're close to that first round, do you come in with a little chip on your shoulder?
You definitely do, because now your money's not the same. But even more than that, it's the prestige. Everyone wants to be a first-round pick, and he thought his talent demanded that. And I do know some teams in the league that had first-round grades on him.
And you take a look at this draft class from a season ago. Really, it grades out as a pretty darn good class.
So you have to give a lot of credit to the entire scouting organization. General manager, personnel department, college scouts all came together. They evaluated it very well and got a nice payoff.
And he's going to be brought down. He needed to get to the 20, but he's a yard or two short.
7 yards.
It would be a very makeable field goal try from here, but instead they're going to go for it. They're going for it. It's Kaepernick. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on 4th down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you know, you and I have both been to practices where we've seen, hey, 3rd down situation, big 3rd down alert, lock in here. 4th down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
Jones with a nice gain there on 1st down as he takes his forward and call it a pickup of 6.
Brought down by Bryce Callahan.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
A gain of 13 yards.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Jones running on 1st down, but finding it pretty tough going as he'll get forward for only about 3 there before he's taken down.
It's a pickup of 3.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mark Barron. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
Denver's offense ready to go again. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick and didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down.
First and 10.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Number 30.
They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And he's eating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
A 1 yard gain.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
That's good for a Denver Broncos.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They'll run here with Freeman. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. A pickup of 4 on first down. It'll be second and goal.
4 yard gain.
When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead because now the...
And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Nick Vanette, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Broncos draw a bit closer.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. And he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. So that drive, 7 plays in length. And it ends with a Denver touchdown. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Here's the Tampa Bay offense and Ronald Jones leading him out. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you've really done some damage in an NFL game.
And now he's looking just to add to his totals. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
34-yard line.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. They'll find Miller, that's complete. 15 yards on the play, first down.
A gain of 15.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. On play action, it's Brady. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. From the gun, it's Brady. Room to run past midfield. He completes this into the hands of Miller. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Prince Amukamara. And the return stops just a little bit shy of midfield at the 48-yard line. So cancel the interception, pass interference.
And you know what else gets canceled? The return yardage. Makes the play, but now it's all for naught.
Brady now on first down. Eluding the pressure right. On the right side, this is Miller. Yeah, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. This is caught. Gronkowski. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line.
First and goal.
A good pickup there. 21 yards.
Love the play call that time. Love the design. You put three tight ends on the field. That screams jumbo set running formation to a defense, right? No, they go play action, and defense gets confused for just a split second. And next thing you know, completion for good yardage.
Throwing now is Brady. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. Nice gain of 8 that time, but it's second and goal.
At the 1-yard line.
And they'll employ the jumbo set now on second and 1. They'll try to run this one in. And this Bronco defense really selling out to stop the run, and it pays off. They get him behind the line twice in a row. Third and goal from the 2, and they're going with a jumbo set offensively. To throw, it's Brady, rolling to his right. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
He is good. Makes the score Buccaneers 13, Broncos 7.
Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get 3 before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. And we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
KJ,
and he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
First and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
All right, Brandon, thanks. And welcome in, everybody, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Time for a look around the NFL here in week 3 of the new year. We'll get started over at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. And it's the Bears who have the lead. Anthony Miller, a touchdown reception. From there, let's head off and check out a second game. And for the moment, they find themselves trailing the visiting Carolina Panthers. Robbie Anderson, a touchdown reception. Finally, let's get to Indianapolis to check on the Colts at home at Lucas Oil Stadium. And it's the visiting Jets who have the lead in that one. The Jets trying to gut this one out, as it would be a good victory for them if they could get it. In the game you're watching, it's who else? Tom Brady with a strong first half. His guys will start the third quarter with the lead as we get you back out to Denver and hand it back over to Brandon Gott.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
The kickoff for Tampa Bay.
It'll be the Broncos getting the football first in this second half as they trail, and we are back underway. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Broncos take over first and 10 at their own.
Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with it. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. One play has them to the 37 here for first and 10. Now Kaepernick. He's got the tight end, Vanette. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll run here with Lindsay. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. William Golston in on the stop.
On the tackle. A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
Kaepernick to throw on second down. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and 6. They'll find Lindsay here. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of 2 there. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. And what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
So here are the Bucs to take over on offense. They've got the lead right now. You remember last week they defeated the Carolina Panthers here. Good momentum. Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at the 20. And he'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. And he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down.
Pretty straightforward play there by the linebacker. He saw the run, went with straight ahead pursuit, and dumped him behind the line of scrimmage.
On second and 15 now, Brady. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. The give is to Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
That's complete to his running back, Evans. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
A gain of 13 yards.
Mike Evans has been so good downfield, I think that sometimes we end up taking him for granted. When you look back at what he's done each year in the league, he's been a 1,000-yard receiver each and every time. Now paired with the prolific Tom Brady, those numbers could really jump.
As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They're looking for Godwin, but it's intercepted. A.J. Boye with a pick, and they will take over at the 26-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
So after the INT, it's Kaepernick. There's the former quarterback, Greg Ward Jr. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
That's good.
Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
At the 36-yard line.
On first down, it's Lindsey. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. That one good for 13 and a Denver first down.
Every year we spend a lot of time and money evaluating the top prospects for the NFL draft. How about when we all get fortunate and see a guy like Philip Lindsay, an undrafted free agent, who had 1,000 yards rushing his first 2 years in the NFL. Can run between the tackles, run with power, and catch the ball in the backfield.
8 more yards this time, coming off back-to-back first down pickups.
Brings up 2nd and
facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Here's a give to Lindsay. And he'll only get a yard to bring up 3rd and 1.
Lindsay, the ball carrier.
And there's the anchor of this line, Big Vita Vea on the tackle, former first-round pick in his 3rd season now out of the University of Washington.
This is 3rd and 1, very likely 4-down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. A run with Lindsay out of the gun. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's going to get it all the way down to the 10-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. That was excellent from start to finish, from the blocking to the running, just well executed.
And now let's look ahead, because after that, how about a little play action, maybe a little bootleg, and get the quarterback out on the corner and give him a little run-pass option.
Well, they're right down here looking for 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. 2nd and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
On 2nd down, here's Kaepernick. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. Andrew Beck there to make the grab. And the Broncos are an extra point away from taking the lead. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
And you remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They used their fullback in pass plays all the time. Roger Craig, Tom Rathman, those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
Mess around and put that thing over your pyramid.
And there's going to be a stoppage here. The booth wants to take another look at this potential touchdown. Get an extra look. That's what the technology is for. And this touchdown working. And this puts him on top by a penny. It's 14-13. That time a 9-play drive. And it culminates in a touchdown by the Broncos. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken in the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. And here we go again with Tom Brady in Tampa's offense. He's hoping to channel his first half play. They had the lead at halftime, was playing well. Flip the script here in the third quarter a little bit.
I think he misses the peewee days, you know, when you just got the orange slice at halftime, right? And remember, weren't any real adjustments then, right? You weren't looking at some tape, right? You weren't looking at stuff off of the Surface tablets. He just went back out and played. Right now, maybe the adjustments have caught up to him.
We'll see. Maybe he just needs a couple orange slices here for this drive.
Brings up second and three at the 32-yard line.
On second down, it's Jones. Quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
That's the reason we ball for circle round twice for the encore. You know, you know.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he'll take this one for about four up to the 40.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. The Bucs on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Now Brady gets away with one. Lucky, could have been intercepted, but it falls to the ground.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
30-yard drive.
Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, give him 14.
Broncos. First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
They'll run on first down. Lindsey. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they turn to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs.
43-yard line.
They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Throw left side complete. That's Lindsey. Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down.
Sam Martin.
That goes in the category of a play that the defense is going to cherish and excites them. A completion, yes, you give up the pass, but no gain. I mean, that's exactly what you want on defense.
It sets up the fourth down.
You hate to give the ball away here in the fourth quarter while you just hold a slim lead, but that punt, absolutely ideal. They pin them inside the 5-yard line. They give their defense a really nice opportunity.
Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They force the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. A few better down a score in the fourth quarter than Tom Brady. This is first and 10. And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down. Trying to escape the shadow of their goalpost. That helped. 10 yards. First down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me. And I'm going to keep firing.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find the answers, and they've got to find them quick.
Number 25.
Give them a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
Dancing to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Scotty
Miller. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. So a big play coming now for the Bucs as they'll go for two. Brady now to throw. And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth-quarter lead. So they go with a pass, and it works there on the two-point try. Charles, just in general, what are your thoughts, passing versus running on two-point conversion? Situational?
It is situational, and you have to know your team. What is your strength? Because so many people think you have to throw the ball on a two-point conversion, but the stats will tell you that running it is about as proficient. So know your team and go to your strength.
KJ Hamler. The Broncos
offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Back to the air on second down. It's Kaepernick. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
By the Buccaneers.
Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Jones. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Jerry Atauchu brings him down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
A good run, 8 yards there, and it'll be second and goal.
The 2 yard line.
Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all your.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
Ronald Jones,
his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So that drive, four plays. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And this will come out to the 25 as Hamler elects not to return it. Now Colin Kaepernick in the offense heading back out onto the field. With his guys trailing here in the fourth, he can ill afford a repeat of the interception that ended the last drive.
Yeah, you're 2 scores down. You take it upon yourself now to play perfect or near-perfect football if you want to get your team back into the game. But it's also tough to do when you're trying to avoid errors, yet still play perfect football.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. He'll get this one to Patrick. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Good. We're on Denver Broncos.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. So it's Bronco football as we get your reset here. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And a loose football. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, that drive wasn't a case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needing
they
to, having to, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, 2 scores, pretty much game, set, match.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll try and run some clock down with Jones, and he'll get this one up to about his 14. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. They'll try and run some clock with Fournette. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Again, it's Fournette. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. A lane to run there as Fournette able to get about 7 on first down.
Fournette, the ball carrier.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. And I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. On second down, here's Fournette. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell 3 times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down.
46-yard line. A gain of 11 on the play. First down, Tampa Bay.
So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
So for the Buccaneers, it's back-to-back victories now after the Week 1 defeat as they move to 2-1. And they will head home next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, for the Broncos, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at MetLife Stadium with the New York Jets. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.